My early life, I grew up in a very small town in Virginia. My father raised everything we ate. He was an uneducated man. My mother was a school teacher, having graduated from what is now Virginia State in 1922. And my goal as a child was to just get off the farm. So here I am, this little country girl, grew up in a small town of about 200 or 300 people, and I went to New York City. Well, after about a couple of years of floundering in New York, I realized that my mother was right. I needed to go to college. So then I enrolled in Howard University in 1962. When I got to Howard, I took a course, Introduction to Business, taught by Professor H. Neil Fitzhugh. He, I found out later, had graduated from Harvard Business School and Harvard College. And I was just so intrigued by this man. He taught a different style using the method they use at the graduate school, which is the case method. His cases were written much shorter and less complicated than ones at the business school. But he would give us a case to read, and then we'd have to analyze the case and come up with a solution. And I was just so intrigued by that method of teaching. And he saw potential, I guess. He saw things in me that I probably did not see in myself. He thought I should go to graduate school. And he said, why not Harvard? And I just looked at him like, you've got to be crazy. I thought everybody who went to Harvard was very, very rich and very, very smart. Now, maybe I could make it on the smart end to some extent, but I certainly was not rich. So I didn't think that was even a possibility. And I was accepted the next year. And then I enrolled in Harvard in 1967. The atmosphere was very cold, the weather was cold, the atmosphere was cold, social life literally non-existent, at least for black women, for many of the women. You didn't really experience overt discrimination. It was more like you were invisible. My class was the class that founded the African American Student Union as a support system for black students who came behind us. And we decided that somebody needed to do something, so why not us? And what we decided to do is go meet with the dean, Dean George Baker at that time, and just find out why there weren't more black students and what could we do. He agreed that if we would go back to our alma maters and other schools to recruit black students at the school's expense, he would go out to corporations and find scholarship money. So he delivered on his promise and we delivered on ours. He found corporations to get scholarship money for black students, and we recruited 27 black students that next year. And each year the numbers grew. I think it got as high as 100, 150. It's leveled off now to about, I think there may be 100 or just over 100 black students in both the first and second year class, but a lot different than when we were there. Being the first black woman to graduate from Harvard Business School, it means a lot to me now. I didn't go there to make history in that way, of course. I went there to get my education, but the meaning and the importance of it has increased over the years for me because I've seen the impact it's had on other people. In 1969, when I graduated from Harvard, I incorporated my company, Centennial One Incorporated. I got my first contract with the Department of Agriculture for $150,000. And then I gradually began to build up commercial contracts over the years. And then I bought a company in Boston a few years later, and I bought a supply company. And all those things helped the business to grow. It means a lot to me to receive the Alumni Award for Distinguished Postgraduate Achievement, because Howard University is where I got my foundation for all the things that happened in my career after that. It's where I started, so having them recognize some of the things that I've done in my career means a lot to me. I'm honored to have been selected to receive it.